Sandals, and so I'm going to decorate these. And I got the idea from seeing a couple like images on Pinterest of like people using like studs and like safety pins, because I am a gothic babe and I have some chains in here too. So it's gonna be quite interesting how we decorate this. And so this is my new countertop space. It's a breakfast bar, and I have my Sagittarius candle, since I am a Sagittarius. Don't come for me in the comments. And I got myself a little midnight snack because it's like 10:30 and I'm hungry. And I could have did this earlier, but I wanted to really build this bar stool. So one of the first things that I build, because tomorrow I'm doing my end table. And so, I want to talk a bit about how it is living in this nice luxury apartment. This apartment is not like any of the normal ones you would see that people would go to. And so, this is, I guess, is what people would call luxury apartment. Ooh, a stud. First pick. You have some very interesting choices here. You got some bones. I wonder about that safety pin I was talking about. And I was thinking about probably taking out one of the croc letters so I can have more space. But yeah, like me, I'm living in a luxury apartment, is what they call them now. And initially, I found this apartment literally by driving on the street one day. I drove by and was like, oh, these are some nice apartments. Because in Texas, so far what I'm learning is that they have most of the apartments are luxury apartments. And so when I was driving around, I literally stopped at every place I could where I was already in Katy. And so I stopped at certain places and asked about like what are the rates for the apartments, and I want to go ahead and tell anyone that's interested in moving to Houston or like around the outer loop is what they call it, around like the west, the north, on the west side, that every week the apartment rates change. And so we have to figure out pretty quickly what you want, because chances are the price will change and then you'll be out of luck. Oh, look, these have hearts. Oh, these are so cool. It's gonna be so hard to choose because I have a stud and a safety pin right now. But yeah, like every week the apartments change, their rent changes, and so you have to catch them while they have it during that week and then get a quote. That's what they call it now. In most places, you actually have to pay utilities. Like right now, I am currently paying sub-meter water, which is based off of how much I use. And I'm paying lights. And then I'm paying for valet trash, which is where they'll come and pick up the trash throughout the week, except for like Fridays and Saturdays. And honestly, it's a pretty cool deal. But you're definitely gonna be paying over $1,000 for this, for these privileges, as they call it. But really, that's the standard now. What this used to be a privilege for some people, but now it's the standard, and that's what everyone has to, you know, be accustomed to. And so I have all this space behind me that's my living room, and I have a balcony in the back, which I'm to this day still trying to figure out how I'm gonna even decorate that, or even how to. Well, I wasn't really planning on entertaining. I was really, my initial goal was to do podcast episodes outside, do my morning talks that I usually do it out on the balcony because my parents are going to be giving me some furniture, bless their hearts. They're going to be giving me some furniture, so I will not just be sitting in the big old empty room with an echo, but I'm hoping this new setup will be good for everyone, and hopefully moving forward will continuously succeed, continuously grow, and continue to push to make more content. I don't know if this is gonna get in the way or if I should put them together. Cause like there's this like fake diamond stud, and then I like the hearts, but I may change the location of this one. I may put them right next to each other, just call it a day. But anywho, so yeah, it's wild and crazy right now when it comes to renting, because I was renting a room that I found on Airbnb, and I made a deal with the host where they let me go into like a lease contract or like a rental agreement so that I could be able to use their address to get my ID and to register my car and my insurance. Because I needed all of that to move to Texas. Because it's like, it's one thing to get a job, but it's another thing to get an actual place to live. So, with all that being said, there's so much involved with what you have to do, but it's not impossible. Because I made it, I stuck it out, and I definitely have so many more stories to tell, because I mean, this is my first time ever having to live with multiple people in one house, and boy, it was quite interesting to say the least, because I had to share a bathroom with someone, and I had to share a refrigerator, and so I couldn't keep, like, you know, groceries long term like how I normally would. So it was a lot of adapting that I had to do beforehand, because at my other place, I only lived with one person, and we both, like, was amicable when it came to sharing the space versus living with four. It is a whole different world. And thankfully, no one ever ate my food. So that's one thing I could be thankful for, is that no one ate my food. And so things are kind of hard to push in, but I want to show you the progress. So this is the right shoe so far. Got my hearts going on here. I may turn this upside down. Yeah, give it a little flare. So trying to figure out what I want to put here. And then for the left side, I might keep this crocs logo for now. And then I have the stud, the skull, and the spike right here. And it's pretty much all the same thing of what I have left over. I do have another safety pin, but I might save it for later. Let's open this bag over right here. So initially, since this is my first night, spending the night in this apartment, I wanted to make a video of me first decorating the shoes, because boy, this is a statement piece right here. But it's one thing to like know about Crocs, and it's another thing to like absolutely decorate. Okay, this is doing the most. I'm not going to do this to myself because I have to wear these. So just take that out. I mean, because I do like some of the, I call them charms, they probably have a different name. I do like all the different options that they have on the Crocs website. And like, I've seen one where you can get like the Akashi Cloud from Naruto, because I love anime. And so, honestly, that's all I might do for now. Like, I might do another spike over here and just leave the rest bare. until I get some more that is a bit more suitable, and I might take this croc logo out as well, and probably it'll be matching if I were to put the safety pin from here to over here too. It may just leave it bare. So that's pretty much it when it comes to apartments in Houston, Texas. Now, I did use an apartment locator as well to look up apartments in my area, because I would every weekend I would take a trip and just drive around my neighborhood to see what apartments was available. And honestly, no matter where you go, the prices get higher and higher. Just living, if you want to live in the Fort Bend County area, which is the city of Katy, or I was also looking into Cypress, Texas, because when it came to the location of my job, where I wanted to live, it was either between Katy and Cypress, because I could still be close to Houston, but not too far away, because really where my initial job is, there's not many apartments available. So I already knew that beforehand and was like, let me look up what's the next major city. And so I found out between those are my two for right now before I actually move into the city of Houston and then deal with traffic. So looking on the outer parameters were those two options, and I decided to go for Katy first and see what it was like. And it's a good vibe. I like Katy. Katy is a nice vibe. It's good for definitely families. I really did not deal with any craziness that I normally dealt with living in Louisiana with the high crime rate. And Katy is actually pretty quiet. The most you will ever deal with is traffic, and I feel like that's just a thing because everyone moves here. But then again, all the job opportunities are here too. And so the reason I chose Katy over Cypress, because Cypress, it reminded me of living in a forest, too many trees. And I was like, yeah, it would be closer, but I'm not really a big fan of the atmosphere. Like, I just wasn't feeling Katy. I mean, Cypress. And so I decided to live in Katy. And then when it came to looking for apartments, I actually made a decision to be on the west side of Houston. So if that were to tell you anything when it comes to price ranges, sometimes being in Houston is a little bit better. It's just you gotta pick your poison. You either going to be on the outskirts and pay a little bit more in Katy or Cypress, or like the Woodlands, Sugarland, Cinco Ranch part of Katy, you're going to be paying above $1,300 for a one bedroom apartment. Versus if you go a little bit closer to Houston, it's a little bit cheaper, but you will be driving out more. So it's your lesser of two evils. In my opinion, I made the best decision based off of my income and what I could afford. And then I had to also factor in, I'm paying utilities, I'm paying for internet. And, that's pretty much it when it came to apartments. And I'm done with my shoes, like I said, for now. I may do a part two so I can show you what I'm going to put here. And I got two other spots here and another spot here. But I'll probably end up wearing them just like this. But I'm pretty proud of that, because I'm a big fan of safety pins. Oh my god, big fan. But yeah, so being on the west side of Houston is going to be interesting. I'm hoping that it will be a good time. I mean, so far I've seen also more families, but more diverse group than I did when I was in Katy. In Katy, I seen a predominantly majority group was there, versus being on the outskirts of West Houston, I'm seeing a bit more diverse groups, diverse minorities. Literally, that's all I see are minorities. And it feels like I live in another country, honestly. I remember when I went to El Paso, Texas, like 2 months ago, and I definitely felt like I was in Mexico because it was so colorful and vibrant, and the people were so friendly, and everything was literally in another language that I could not understand. And I was like, wow, this is really what it's like whenever you leave Louisiana, because Louisiana, I'm just so used to the Cajun people, the Cajun food, and all of the ins and outs and the craziness, the humidity, the football season, the Mardi Gras season. But when it comes to Texas, I'm learning about cowboys, the rodeo. I learned about different festivals that they have here. The huge archival world, which is the world that I'm in right now. And there's so much more to learn because I've only been here for 4 months. And so I am pretty excited to learn more. And can't wait to show you an apartment tour once I get everything settled.